Hi, it's Alan from Crashtest Security. In this video, I will tell you more about server-side includes mechanism, how attackers exploit it to orchestrate cyber attacks, common SSI attacks and examples. So let's get started. In web development, directives define custom tags translated to regular JavaScript, Hangul or CSS to modify a page's document object model. Server-side inclusion represents the directives in a web document's request header field that instructs the server to include additional data within the Hangul output for dynamic content delivery. Server-side includes is a mechanism that helps developers insert dynamic content into Hangul files without requiring knowledge of the server or client-side programming language specification. When the edge server executes an SSI, it reads through the file's contents, finds the directives, acts on them, and then sends the resulting file to the browser client app. This makes SSI a powerful feature for applications such as dynamic content assembly. The file includes inserting standard header files, displaying content file sizes, and last modified dates. In instances where a web server accepts user controllable input and includes it in response headers that are parsed for SSI directives, attackers can inject directives or modify existing ones for malicious purposes. This attack mechanism is commonly known as the SSI injection attack, which allows the adversary to execute malicious server code or gain access to content initially meant to be hidden. SSI injection attacks arise as a result of various inherent vulnerabilities of an application, including improper neutralization of directives in static code, improper output encoding and escaping, failure to sanitize particular elements. Primary SSI directives include config. The config command is a control directive to modify various SSI components. Includes parameters such as the default server error message, ERMSG, file size format, sizeif, and date and time format, timefont. Echo inserts SSI and CGI environment variables values while including optional encoding arguments. Exec executes an external application, following which the execution output is inserted into the document. This control directive supports CMD arguments from any client app or a CHI program. Flastmod, the last time and data specified file was modified. It accepts both a virtual path, virtual, and a relative pathname file as arguments for locating the document on the server. Include inserts text from another document into the current file. It also accepts file and virtual arguments to locate the document. Printenv displays all environment variables within the server. Set, a control directive that sets a server-side variable to the specified value. Attackers can remotely perform arbitrary server code execution or inject malicious scripts into HTML pages and response headers by exploiting SSI vulnerabilities. Some commonly known examples of SSI exploits include discovering SSI vulnerabilities. Attackers test whether the application is vulnerable to SSI injection by inserting characters used in SSI directives into input fields, like the code shown in the video. Adversaries can also determine whether an application accepts SSI directives by searching for pages with a STM, SHTM, and SHTML file extensions. Attackers can manipulate OAuth processes and file systems under the hood if a web server permits SSI directives without input validation. OAuth command execution. These commands target manipulating the origin server's operating system to access files and perform privileged actions. The commands vary according to the operating system deployed on the server. Examples of Linux command exploits include listing the files in the current directory, accessing server configuration files of the root directory, executing an external script. Examples of Windows command exploits include listing files within a directory, gaining access to content within a directory. Older versions of the Internet Information Services IIS server software include a significant vulnerability within the dynamic link library, SYNCL, that permits buffer overflows. Attackers use this library while exploiting the interpreter that processes the SSI directives from client devices. A typical attack flow involves the following orchestration stages. First, the attacker creates a malicious page with relevant code, similar to the code shown in the video. Quick note: for a successful attack, the number of us is usually longer than 2049. Assuming this page is called cpayloadhell and is hosted on the attacker's website www.attackers-bad-site.com, the hacker will force the application to load the page via a path traversal attack, assuming the legitimate page had a URL similar to www.darwin.com/index.asp. Page equals client SASP. The attacker will craft a query string, redirecting the request to a malicious URL of the form. www.darwin.com/index.asp. Page equals www.attackersbadstay.com/c/shem. A blank page returned by the IIS service implies a successful buffer overflow operation, which the hacker can further exploit to manipulate data flows and execute malicious code. Access and set server configuration details. SSI exploits are most commonly used to access and configure server information. These include changing the server error response message output, displaying the file name of the current document, displaying when the document was last modified, displaying the file name and virtual path, displaying the region's date, controlling the format of the date and current time output, accessing the size of a selected log file using the FIES command. Try Crashtest Security today to discover how it integrates into your development stack for efficient, automated vulnerability scanning. The trial is free. Also, subscribe to the Crashtest Security channel to get more information about the most significant web security threats, their prevention, and how to use the Crashtest Security Suite. Thank you for watching, and see you in our next video.